Did your audition for this film involve getting rained on at all?
No. I didn't have to audition because I did Jeff's first movie, Shotgun Stories, so that passed for an audition. But actually, it wasn't a sure thing that I was going to play Curtis. The first time I read Take Shelter, it was just as a friend to get his... he wanted my opinion on the script, and I told him what I thought. And then a couple of years went by, and he called me up and asked me to do it. So
he obviously took your notes and went, "These are such good notes."
I didn't have any. I told him, I said, "I think this is a beautiful script, but I feel sorry for whoever plays Curtis. That's not going to be much fun." So, and then he said, "Well, it's going to be you.
I'm going to punish you."
Yeah, exactly.
And this is just a point of curiosity, you know, early on in the film, you get rained on by droplets of what appears to be oil.
Oh, yeah, that was an interesting day when they were making that rain. Actually, quite a lot of thought went into that rain, and quite a lot of ingredients went into that rain. There's Vaseline, and how'd they make it orange? It wasn't motor oil. I think maybe they put some sort of Kool-Aid or some sort of beverage in it. But yeah, it was very unpleasant, that stuff. But fortunately, I only had to do it a couple of times. So there's worse things I've had to put up with. Yeah.
Now, you are becoming known, dare I say it, for having an incredible screen presence, but you tend to play these characters that are kind of tortured souls. Mm. Have you ever been tempted just to branch out and just throw them for six and do a musical?
I used to do musicals when I was in high school. I was in Bye Bye Birdie. I was in The Girlfriend. But I was just a dancer in The Girlfriend. I didn't have any lines. But then I crossed over to The Pit. I think if I did musicals, I'd be in The Pit because I like to play the bass on the musicals. But I don't know. Have there been any really good movie musicals lately?
Certainly not fun ones, anyway.
That's the question. Yeah. I think I've probably grossly insulted somebody, but I'm not sure who.
Screw it.
Yeah.
Now tell me, did you freak out when you first met Martin Scorsese?
No, he freaked out. He's been like, "Michael Shannon, I've been wanting to meet you since I made Goodfellas." No. No, yeah, I freaked out. I also was very tired the first time I met him, which is not what you don't want to be tired the first time you meet Martin Scorsese, but it wasn't really up to me. I was working on something else at the time, and I'd been shooting all day, and it was one of those situations where they kept calling every 15 minutes saying, "Are you done yet? Are you done yet?" And then I got stuck in traffic. I was driving across from Yonkers to Manhattan at rush hour. And they would call every 5 minutes. They're like, he's gonna leave. So by the time I got there, I was like, it was Terrence Winter, it was the Boardwalk Empire meeting. And he just started talking. He was like, "Well, you know, Michael, the thing is, what was happening in Atlantic City at the time, went back to Italy, and Italy did this thing." I thought I was gonna have an aneurysm or something. But once I got the part and we were actually shooting, we shot a night scene a lot. We were shot a lot of nights, actually. So at 3 or 4 in the morning, it was a little more tranquil, yeah, mellow.
When people stop you in the street and recognize you, what do they tend to say? Why did you do
Thank
that?
"Thank you for ruining my life." No.
I get that, too.
Yeah. What do they say? Well, one guy in New York, I was with my family. I have a girlfriend and a little daughter, and he was riding by on his bicycle, and he didn't say anything when he was riding by, but he got to the end of the block, and he turned around, and he yelled down the street, he yelled, "8 Mile, you screwed the mom." So that's one notable thing.
You must love it when they just say the name of the film.
Yeah,